touring the world, playing all over on a boat. And they are joined today by two of our old Nedfest friends, Keith Moseley and Scott Messersmith. Please welcome Stell and Snugs.
Thank you. Thank you all very much. That's a little tune we named after our little, our tour boat called Catherine. So it's a little Cumbia Catarina.
Wow. I need an oxygen tank for sure. I live on sea level, so bear with me. So it's good. It's good. Thanks so much. All right, what are we doing next, Jarad?
We're going to do a little song. We wrote this little song at sea. You know, one thing you do get at sea is either really excited or really bored. They say it's 99% boredom and 1% sheer terror. And there's not really much in between. And this was one of those nice boredom times. And we're trying to catch a little fish. And we had these birds circling around our fishing lure. Thought they were going to try and take it, get caught up in it, which is kind of bad luck at sea, I think, you know. Not doing that on purpose. Turned out this little bird, he's just looking at the damn thing. He's so bored. He's as bored as we were. A little pink lure in the middle of a big blue sea. He just kept doing it, followed us for 3 days and kept checking it out. We wrote this little tune about him called Hey Little Bird.
That's what it says on the back of my boat. You think that'd turn him away. He has some big old cojones on him, man. Looked me in the face and he said, hey little man, hey little man, what the hell you doing out here? Hey little man, do you mind if I stop and stare? Hey little man, what do you got right there? You can't bet I'm gonna come on back and take that little fishy out of your. One more time. And I said, hey little bird, hey little bird, tell me baby where you gone. Hey little bird, hey little bird, you going all alone. Hey little bird, hey little bird, looks like you just a rolling stone. You can bet I'm gonna pull that in and that little fish is gonna be gone. Stubborn cuss, isn't he? Does he have a couple of friends? Oh my God, he's got more birds with him. All the way to hell out here. What, are you gonna look me in the eye? That bird, he said, hey little man, tell me, babe, where you come from? Hey little man, don't you know you out here all alone? Hey little man, oh, you better know. Come on, you gotta cut me a break, boy. I'm trying to catch me some dinner. So I said, hey, little bird, come on, why don't you go get on home? Hey, little bird, come on, leave that damn fishy alone. Hey, little bird, well, there's something that you gotta know. It ain't no magic. It's just a piece of plastic. And if you swallow it, it's gonna get stuck right there in your throat. That's why we don't let no plastic go in the sea, baby.
Can I please?
Yeah, a little fun bit right there.
Please have more accordion in this monitor and a little more of this mic, please. Thank you.
And a little more upper end accordion in there too.
All right, so we're gonna do another. You know, we just write songs about everything that we see. We don't make up crazy business. We're not that creative, you know what I mean? Simple sailing people. So this is a little song. We wrote this song in St. Croix. We was hanging out on a friend's boat. And what do you all think happens when you're hanging out on somebody's boat? What happens? You're drinking a lot. She's a smart young lady. Come on. So we's drinking a lot. We basically drank all the rum between two boats. And the only thing left was red wine. And we just did not think it was a good idea to stop. We thought it was a better idea to put the red wine on top of the rum. And that's what this little tune's about here, about how bad of an idea that shit is.
Spirits run empty, we'll just hit the holy wine.
for that sun to ride. Yes, we'll pray for the sun to ride. I see the love deep within you. All right, we're going to do a little classic for you. We like to do a lot of cumbia melodies, and I love that feel. It makes me feel like I'm in the Caribbean somewhere, you know what I mean? The Western Caribbean, maybe.
Thank you.
lessons. I got a crazy teacher that wears dark glasses. I said things are going great, they're only getting better. Yeah, I'm doing all right, getting good grades, and my future's so bright. I got to wear shade, I got to wear shade, I got to wear shade, shade, I got to wear shade. I got to wear shade, shade, I got to wear shade. I got to wear shade, shade, I got to wear shade. I got to wear shade. Y'all look good with your shades on today, I'll tell you what, man.
Europe, so it's got that little feel to it. Not very bluegrassy. Thank you.
Not bad for government work up here, not bad.
Thank you. Yeah. That's a brand new song. We just wrote that a couple weeks ago. So thanks for letting us unleash it on you.
Thank you.
Yes.
Yeah, we can experiment on these people. They like it. That's why they live up here. They don't even know it, really. You know, I remember when I was living up here, people would experiment on me, and I wouldn't even notice because the oxygen deprivation was just constant. We're going to do a little song for you from Trinidad. Trinidad is a small country just off the coast of Venezuela. It's part of the Caribbean island chain and has a very, very rich history of calypso music. It's actually the origination of Carnival. So it's the OG Carnival, and they still have these amazing carnivals and amazing calypso music competitions. And it goes way, way back, and this little tune here was written in 1923 by a man by the name of Lord Kitchener, who is kind of a bit of a Trinidadian national hero and was very good at, as many people were in the 20s, of writing dirty songs with not a single cuss word in them. It's a little tune called The Needle. I am not a qualified physician, and I do not want to get this injection. I'm not a qualified physician, and I do not want to get this injection. This girl, she's begging for trouble. She insists that I give her this needle. But darling, one thing I want you to know, don't blame her for where the needle goes. I push it in. She pulls it out. Dr. Kitch, you're terrible. I can't stand the size of your needle.
Hey.
What seems to be the problem today, miss?
I'm not feeling so good, doctor. I think I need an injection.
Well, you came to the right place, miss. I'm a professional. Just, if you wouldn't mind, just put this robe on and I'll see you in just a second. She lied down in such a position, I make it difficult to give the injection. She start holding on to the needle, I'm making me feel so uncomfortable. I said, darling, can't you keep steady? I'm going to be done very shortly. She said, Dr. Kitch, I'm so sorry, but the size of your needle frightens me. I push it in. She pull it out, I push it back. Shut up, the kids, you terrible! I can't stand the size of your needle.
Aye, 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 daughter.
Okay, miss, if you wouldn't mind, just open up and say ah. Well, everything looks good in there. Okay, I think we are gonna have to give you a little injection. I know this might make you a little nervous, so it might just be best for you to close your eyes during the process.
Okay.
Okay, ready? We'll keep a nice count to three.
One, three.
Two. Ay, ay, ay. Oy, mommy. She still would not lie down so quietly, constantly moving her body. So I slapped her in the face with fixation and continue on giving the injection. She said, doctor, stop, I can't stand the pain. I don't think you inside the right vein. I said, you little fool, you wouldn't be told. Looks like the needle stuck in the wrong hole. I push it in. She pull it out, I push it back. She stopped to shout, doctor, kid, she terrible. I can't stand the size of your needle. Thank you.
from that hole and start again. I now have the needle in the right vein. The needle just gone in half an inch. The silly young lady start to freak. Suddenly she crying as she feeling dark. I can see the penicillin going in. I said, you little girl, what you do? You talk until the needle breaking you. I push it in, yeah.
Nice, nice, yeah, man. Put it together for my man Keith Moseley and Scott Messersmith up in here, man. You know, I'm trying to figure out how to smuggle them back to my boat, you know, like stick them in a little bag and take them on the plane, maybe. I don't, what do you guys think about that? It might be an uncomfortable ride, but once you get there, you'll be really happy, I promise. We'll stick a couple of bottles of rum in there for you. All right. Scott's like, just buy us tickets. We'll come on the plane regularly. Yeah, I guess that is the better way to go. All right, all right. All right, we're going to do a little song here. This is a little song. I wrote this thing about my crazy uncle. You know, it's like, this is State of America. This is a guy who worked his butt off his whole life and kind of realized that he was just not going to be able to retire at 72. And he's kind of crazy. So his solution was to take his money to Mexico, along with this poor 74-year-old wife who had never taken a plane anywhere and never had a driver's license. So now they're living on the Yucatan Peninsula, and he's a great yarn spinner, so it's kind of like my version of what his BS story about his life in Mexico would be.
Where I wanna be. Ooh, spicy booze on getting mighty tight.
Right, all right. You gotta watch out for your young ladies. The men out there, they're ruthless.
Children to crawl on the floor. Whoa.
smart woman give to the man her love only true. The back door, she gon' let him come. He knows that the only one will bring her pain, but if he loses her, she might let him come back again. The house might feel empty, but that's just fine. The little ones, he only interrupt the wine. So keep them knocking on your back door. Don't want no children to crawl on the floor.
Alright, 7 minutes that we're giving the thing here, 7 minutes left. Check this out. Alright, we're gonna do a little business here. We're gonna do a new song here. It's a little song about hurrying up and waiting. Hurrying up and waiting. You know, we're always waiting for one thing here, one thing or another. I'm sure y'all know that. That business. There's gonna be a little parade of kids coming around. One thing that I'm waiting for is people to stop being kind of silly with all the plastic and stuff that we use, you know? Don't mean so much when you find it on the side of the road. It's just kind of ugly. But where we live on the sea, man, you find it everywhere. It's killing seabirds, it's killing dolphins and turtles, it's killing whales. It's probably killing us on some level sooner or later. So these little kids are coming around with some cups that we're basically raising money for, and we're gonna be giving them out in the Caribbean, trying to get people to just stop using plastic businesses that get thrown out. In the meantime, I want to thank you all so much. We're Stell and Snugs.
So strong in the moonlight, we in this town. Catch that speed, this whip is feel so fine. Baby lover, you ain't no crime.
Festival. We'll see
Thank
you out
there.
You know, thank you guys so much for the sound. You guys
Thank
did a great
you.
Job.
Thank you. CDs and shirts are back there. Thank you so much.